And I want to talk to you about the magic bowl of cures. So many of us hopefully wait for the next cure. In grade schools and high schools, they talk about the fact that maybe you will be the person that cures cancer. Well, here's the truth. The cure to cancer with a magic bullet will never be found. How many times have we been told this? We're just about to cure cancer, yet the US spends over $50 billion per year on cancer treatment and research. Susan Komen Foundation has us walking, putting ribbons on everything and pumping us full of false hope, yet cancer rates continue to rise. If you sit back and you think about it for just a second, how is a magic bullet cure going to reverse years of poor decision making? Are we to believe that we can pop a pill or stay overnight in a hospital for a few days for surgery or chemotherapy and that somehow we'll magically shed all our diseases overnight? Only through accepting responsibility for your condition, that you, your parents, or your community created this condition, and that it's going to require your participation and work to get better, will you ever be healed. Somehow, though, the connection is not made that obesity, cancer, and diabetes took years to develop. And in order to even have a remote chance of healing from these, time and energy is needed to be taken to roll back the damage. But you can be healed. It can be done. That's why I'm standing here talking to you. But it's going to require your own participation in the process. The American Holistic Medical Association defines medicine as this: a system of healthcare which emphasizes personal responsibility and fosters cooperative relationships between all of those involved, leading towards optimal attainment of body, mind, and spirit. There are no quick, easy solutions when it comes to healing. Healing must take time. It must be done in a very specific order. It must utilize the principles that created the human body. The basis and foundation of medicine lies in four theories. And when you begin to understand that these four theories are faulty, therefore you're forced to reject the concept of magic bullets and medicine when you become ill. The first theory is this: that disease is created by unwanted germs that just happen to be floating in the air. And if you happen to walk past one of these germs and breathe it in, then you're going to get sick. To fight these germs, we must vaccinate and try to create artificial immunity to kill the germs where we find them, or use antibacterial agents like alcohol, Lysol, Purell, or antibiotics. If these germs do gain hold, we can use powerful drugs to try to fight them and kill the germs, viruses, funguses when we find them. And if we win the fight, if we somehow eradicate all bacteria, then we'll be healthy. The second theory is this: that chemical imbalances outside of our control, created mostly by bad genes, bad luck, create most of our health issues. And so what medicine tells us is that we need to use new chemicals to try to fix the chemical imbalances. And all chemicals have the ability to do is speed up or slow down reactions. And somehow, by using one chemical to balance the other chemical, man-made, that we're going to somehow create health out of this. The third theory is that all health challenges require doctor intervention. Health challenges like being born, going through puberty, every little cold, flu, every time we stub our toe, aging, menopause, death, and somehow without doctors that we wouldn't be able to work through these things on our own. And the fourth is that all imbalances within the system need to be named and coded, and only then can they be treated. This naming system is purposely designed to be so confusing that very few can understand it. That's why there's 69,000 different diagnoses. And the sole purpose of these is to quantify your condition so then it can be treated through a system of insurance and reimbursement, but only with drugs and surgery. The last set of magic bullets that we were sold is that if we would map the human genome, that somehow we would be able to bioengineer cures to all diseases. This happened about 15 years ago, and the world waited with bated breath, and we're still waiting. And now we're turning blue. Well, you can breathe now, because the truth is that epigenetics is what is the cause of disease. Let's say you have the genetic weakness of heart disease. People in your family have died from it before. Well, the truth is that genetic weakness can only be activated through lifestyle. So let's say you have a high-stress job. You wake up every morning, your alarm goes off, and you have to fight traffic to get through your job. You live in a polluted concrete jungle. When you go to work, you're bombarded by Wi-Fi. You drink chlorinated water. And when you're not drinking that, you're drinking soda or coffee. You eat nutritionless food. You never exercise. You go home at night and you watch political campaigns and are in a constant state of fear and stress. Well then, yes, you can activate that genetic weakness for heart disease. If you want to cure disease, if you want to cure obesity, don't tie your stomach in a knot. If you want to cure cancer, don't go and get chemotherapy. If you want to cure heart disease, don't pour other chemicals that are designed to force change in your body. Do this. Change your environment. Allow your body's epigenetics to activate the good genes instead of the bad genes. Angelina Jolie recently cut off her breast despite the fact that there was no cancer in them because she had a genetic marker that said that she could get cancer. I also read that she was considering getting a full hysterectomy as well, even though there was no cancer in her organs. Essentially, she was going to castrate herself completely from the fear of a test that actually only has a 10% likelihood of actually happening. Angelina, if you're listening to this, please, please, do not mutilate your beautiful body. Do this. Move to Costa Rica. Buy Mel Gibson's estate. I saw it's for sale right now. Enjoy your life. And if you want, hire me. I will become your personal physician. The truth is this. When your body is stressed, it will break. Using a medication or procedure to try to offset the effects of your body breaking will do nothing more than actually increase the stress in your body. According to the Center of Disease Control, 9 out of the top 10 leading causes of death are created by nutritional deficiencies and poor lifestyle. Yet, insurance does not pay for nutritional supplements or lifestyle coaching. Why? The top 10 leading causes of death in this country are: number 1, side effects from medication; number 2, heart disease; number 3, cancer; 4, chronic respiratory disease; number 5, accidents; number 6, Alzheimer's; number 7, diabetes; number 8, pneumonia; number 9, kidney disease; and number 10, septicemia. Can you guess which of these 10 is actually not created by nutritional deficiencies or lifestyle? I'm reminded of the Dr. Royal Lee quote when he said, "One of the biggest tragedies of human civilization is the precedence of chemical therapy over nutrition. It's a substitution of artificial therapy over nature, of poison over food, in which people are fed poison in trying to correct the reactions of starvation." As you begin to learn the truth that you and only you can heal yourself, you will take a perceptible shift towards the truth. The world's veil will be lifted, and you will learn to understand the real truth in medicine, that it's easy, it's free, and that you can heal yourself.